And a very pleasant good evening, everybody, and a very happy Mother's Day to all of you moms out there. As always, it's great to have you with us tonight. I'm Max Winitz. First tonight, $21.4 billion, according to the National Retail Federation. That's how much money we plan to spend on our moms this Mother's Day. ABC7's Kate Flexter took a look at what Suncoast residents are doing for their moms and how that's affecting businesses. Kate?
Max, local retailers and restaurants are saying that Mother's Day is as busy and good for business as last year, if not more so.
At Flowers by Edie in Bradenton on Sunday, the doors were uncharacteristically open for any last-minute Mother's Day purchases.
Thank you very much.
Inside, florists worked quickly to finish each order and accommodate new ones.
It's been busy all week. It's been exceptionally busy Mother's Day.
Mark Clark has co-owned the business for 30 years and says Florida's always been a big place for Mother's Day flowers.
Everybody's mother lives in Florida, you know, so people call us from all over the country, all over the world, actually.
He also says he saw an increase in business following the upturn in the economy.
And in the past, before the recession, of course, Mother's Day was always so busy. Then it did cut back down for quite a few years, but now it seems like things are starting to rebound. We do feel like that the economy is coming back a little bit.
And this year won't be much different. According to the National Retail Federation, Americans are expected to spend an average of $172 on their mothers this year. And 27% of those purchases will be made online. Greeting cards are the most common gift, but also the least expensive. The most is spent on jewelry, closely followed by outings like brunch. The Blue Jasper Cafe in Bradenton was packed for the occasion.
It's been busy. We thought season might be over, but it is still here.
Owner Hillary J. Chondarin says her customers were looking to come in and spend longer than usual, sharing a meal with family.
Relaxing and enjoying, and we've had a lot of people just sitting and drinking coffee today and just enjoying each other's company.
In total, spending is actually expected to exceed the numbers from Valentine's Day. Back to you.
All right, Kate, thank you so much. Switching gears now, five teenagers are sent to the hospital after an early morning car crash in Sarasota County. It happened on Caminer Drive around 5:30 this morning. According to Florida Highway Patrol, the driver of the Acura MDX, 16-year-old Noah Gagan, jumped a curve and then crashed the vehicle into a tree. He, along with four of his passengers, all between 16 and 18 years old, were transported to Sarasota Memorial Hospital for serious injuries. Gagan is charged with careless driving, resulting in serious bodily injury. It appears alcohol was not a factor in the crash. Today marks the final day of business for the Gulfgate Golf Course in Sarasota County. A plan to build more than 100 homes on the grounds is moving forward. The new Medallion home development has the Sarasota County Planning Commission's approval. That's after continued opposition from Gulfgate residents who, among other things, are unhappy about walls being put up with the planned development and the increase in traffic it could bring. The proposed development still needs approval from county commissioners. The modern pentathlon is wrapping up here on the Suncoast. Athletes are competing to work toward a spot in the Summer Olympics in Rio. Competitors and spectators come from around the world for the games. And today's events at Nathan Benderson Park.
Well, I'm very sports-minded.
And equestrian jumping and men's swimming taking place at the Sarasota YMCA.
Sports-minded, and I think this is unique. I've never been subject to fencing or equestrian running. I did some running, but it's all new to me, and they're very athletic athletes, and it's just great to see.
The Summer Olympics in Rio begin on Friday, August 5th. Let's head on over to Wendy Ross now for a first look at our forecast. Wendy?
And Max, it was a perfect day for everyone today. We saw temperatures that climbed up into the 80s. Once again, the humidity was low. So no matter how warm it got, it was very comfortable outside. And right now we're looking at temperatures in the 70s, and we've got plenty of sunshine around. The winds are coming in out of the west-southwest, so off the Gulf of Mexico. As you can see all around the area, we have temperatures in the 70s right at the beaches. You get away from the beach, you've got temperatures still very close to the mid-80s, and there isn't a cloud around. We just have a couple of rain showers with clouds, of course, around Louisiana, a far cry from being here, and we are not expecting to see any rain developing for tonight. So it's going to be a beautiful night if you have a barbecue, a picnic, whatever you're planning to do this evening, you'll be able to do it. We're looking at our temperatures that are going to continue to be very comfortable, with readings dropping into the 70s for the next couple of hours, and plenty of fair skies for tonight. Max.
Wendy, thank you. A Sarasota City Commissioner will go on trial this week. Susan Chapman is accused of breaking open government rules in October 2013 when she and Commissioner Suzanne Atwell attended a meeting with downtown merchants discussing the homeless. Atwell has settled her case, but Chapman denies doing anything wrong. So far, the city of Sarasota has spent more than $250,000 defending Chapman. The bench trial will begin on Tuesday, and it should last about 2 days. A nice Mother's Day to spend outside today in downtown Sarasota for the Downtown Craft Festival. The festival, held at Five Points Park, is considered one of the best craft fairs in Sarasota. The show features the work of more than 100 artists and crafters from around the country.
I think it's nice. It's got a good variety and lots of pretty flowers.
Some of the most popular items for sale at the festival included body products, pottery, and homemade candles. Still to come here tonight on ABC 7, when the hunter becomes the hunted. We'll tell you what happened to an Orlando area man during an alligator hunting trip that sent him to the hospital. We'll have that story and more when we come back. But first, a live look at our Osprey cam. Our Osprey Sarah celebrating Mother's today with her newborn, Sunny. If you'd like to watch the Ospreys, just log on to our website, mysuncoast.com. We have a feed right there on the homepage.
Wish my mom, who's at home, Jennifer, she's in Valrico in Tampa, and I want to wish her a very happy Mother's Day.
My mom means a lot to me. She's my best friend. I mean, last night I waited up till 12 o'clock to message her Happy Mother's Day.
Well, she's influenced me in my career, and being who I am today, just instilling great values in me and things like that.
Happy Mother's Day, Mom.
What does it mean when New South Window says factory direct?
It means we have a factory.
It means we eliminate the middleman.
It means you get an award-winning, energy-efficient window at factory direct pricing.
Plus, New South windows are made in Florida.
Fort Florida home.
By Florida workers.
Because we know Florida weather.
Right now, buy two windows, get the third free. Plus, our lifetime warranty. New South Window. We manufacture. We install. We guarantee. Call now.
It's Ram Truck Month, and that means big savings on some of America's best vehicles at Sunset Dodge Chrysler Jeep Ram in Sarasota. Get America's best value, a new Grand Caravan for just $18,999, or a new Dodge Journey for just $17,999. Stop by today to shop the area's biggest selection of Ram trucks and save up to $8,000 on your new Ram. Better prices, bigger selection. Go to Sunset Dodge Chrysler Jeep Ram in Sarasota.
On your TV, on your computer, on your camera, on your smartphone, on your Apple Watch. And now you can get ABC7, your Suncoast News, on Roku. Just go to mysuncoast.com and click on the mobile tab for a list of fast and free downloads that deliver ABC7, your Suncoast News, on the go. Have you ever wondered what it's like to save a life? Find out by donating platelets at Suncoast Blood Bank.
I'm Haley Wilgus, ABC 7. Platelets aid in the clotting process and are vital in the treatment of cancer and surgical patients, trauma victims, and critically ill newborns. It's tough to keep enough on the shelves because they only last 5 days. To donate, call this number or visit scbb.org, and you can help save a life.
ABC 7 congratulates Suncoast Blood Bank on 65 years of serving our community.
Welcome back. The Tampa Police Department in mourning tonight, remembering the life of one of their own. Officer Howard Gimble, a 20-year veteran with the force, died following an off-duty motorcycle crash. The cause of the crash is still being investigated. This is video of Gimble from a few years ago when he was recognized for his service by the Tampa Bay Lightning. Gimble's wife was also injured in the crash. She is in stable condition at the hospital. Gimble was 52 years old. A man from Central Florida is recovering after being bit by an alligator. 41-year-old Brian Rome and his son were gator hunting in Lake County near Orlando when it happened. Authorities say Rome shot an alligator twice. He thought it was dead. Turns out it wasn't. As he tried to get the reptile on his boat, the gator bit his hand. He was taken to Orlando Regional Medical Center for treatment, and the alligator managed to escape. Also in Lake County, two adults and a child are recovering from injuries after a boat fire. Two men and a baby were burned before their boat ever left the dock. Investigators aren't sure what started the fire. An explosive sound came from the boat in Lake Harris. Within minutes, paramedics hurried to help the burn victims and prepare them for a helicopter transport. And firefighters tried to put out the flames, but they raged on, destroying the family's 12-foot vessel.
The baby screaming and hollering and all that there, and that really hurt. The more water they put on, the worse the fire got.
Officials pulled the boat from the lake hours later. Another adult, the child's mother, was also there, but she was not hurt. Florida Fish and Wildlife is investigating. The first U.S. cruise ship to Cuba in more than 50 years has returned to the U.S. The Carnival ship docked in Miami this morning with American tourists on board. The ship was on a 7-day voyage and stopped at all major ports in Cuba, including Havana. The cruise was made possible after Cuba loosened its restrictions on Cuban-born natives returning to the island on cruise ships. In Canada, a massive wildfire continues to burn, forcing even more residents out of their homes. Some of them have taken shelter in a sports hall in Western Canada. About 90,000 people have left Fort McMurray, which is in the heart of Canada's oil sands. The fire has torched 1,600 homes and other buildings.
It looked like the place would be all burned, and I'm scared if my house would be burned down, my room, my stuff, my clothes. And I'm scared if my school will be burned too.
Experts say unless the region sees significant rainfall, the fire will likely burn for months. Well, so much for being united, or I should say so much for being united behind the nominee. Donald Trump lashing out at Republicans who won't support him for president and at the same time firing blistering attacks at Hillary Clinton. But he's also revealing some of his plans may have to change.
And in my opinion, the taxes for the rich will go up somewhat.
The likely Republican nominee already walking back his tax plan.
No, in my plan, they're going down, but by the time it's negotiated, they'll go up.
During a one-on-one interview with ABC's George Stephanopoulos, Donald Trump also says he doesn't need a unified Republican Party to become president.
I actually don't think so. I think that...
It doesn't have to be
no,
unified?
No, I don't think so.
If
I
had
in the traditional sense, because I think I'm going to go out and I'm going to get millions of people from the Democrats. I'm going to get Bernie people to vote.
Trump's comments come as the rift inside the GOP appears to be deepening. Big names refusing to endorse the candidate, like House Speaker Paul Ryan. The two will meet on Capitol Hill next week, but already Trump supporter Sarah Palin says she will work to oust the most powerful Republican in Congress.
His political career is over, but for a miracle, because he has so disrespected the will of the people.
Even Democratic frontrunner Hillary Clinton weighing in on the bitter feud.
The Republicans themselves are raising questions about their presumptive nominee.
Clinton vowing to stay out of any name-calling with Trump, even as he blasted the former Secretary of State and her husband.
She's married to a man who was the worst abuser of women in the history of politics.
Clinton says she'll stick to the issues and pick up any voters disillusioned by the likely GOP nominee.
Obviously, I'm reaching out to Democrats, Republicans, Independents. I am asking people to come join this campaign, and I've had a lot of outreach from Republicans in the last days.
But first, she must beat fellow Democrat Bernie Sanders to the nomination. And top officials with the Ted Cruz campaign are convinced they could have stopped Donald Trump if Marco Rubio had become the Texas senator's running mate. Several sources close to Cruz said secret polls were conducted in March to test the waters of a Cruz-Rubio unity ticket, resulting in a 65-35% blowout against Trump. A source close to Rubio says there never really was a concrete offer from the Cruz campaign to team up, but he was not interested. Someone in New Jersey is waking up a multimillionaire. One ticket matched all six numbers in Saturday night's Powerball drawing. The jackpot grew from $415 million to an estimated $429 million at the time of the drawing. The winner can either take a one-time payment of more than $280 million or choose to get the entire amount in installments spread out over the next 30 years.
Oh, those are wonderful, wonderful choices.
What would you do?
Oh, I'd take it in the lump sum, of course. I think that's the way to go. Yeah. I don't want to wait around 30 years to get it all, right? But we didn't have to wait at all for this beautiful weather. It was one of those gorgeous days. If we can, I was hoping we could take a look outside and let you see how nice it is still. But we got up to a high of 84 degrees, and because the humidity was so low, it was very comfortable out there. Temperatures were back down in the 50s last night. 57 was the overnight low, and 84 degrees the day. Daytime high. We're right on track with that high temperature. That's what it's supposed to be for this time of the year. We did have a record high of 93 degrees set back in 1929. And right now it's 79, plenty of sunshine out there. The humidity is still low. Those winds coming in out of the west southwest at around 10 miles per hour. So there's a nice breeze, mostly coming in from the Gulf of Mexico. And as you can see, we have very warm temperatures still around the state. Jacksonville at 89, almost 90 degrees, and we're also looking at 86 degrees in Gainesville. So some of those places, the hot spots, Tallahassee also reporting 86. The rest of us coming in the 70s and 80s across Central and South Florida. And for us, we're starting to see more 70s now. Parrish reporting 77, Lakewood Ranch the same. You get a little farther to the east. Mayaca City is at 84, Punta Gorda at Marcadia, and Wachula in the low 80s right now. So it's still very, very warm. At the beaches, it's just a little bit warmer. Well, that dry air is still sitting on top of us. You can see all across the southeast that drier air all the way down through the state of Florida. And we are going to continue to see dry conditions over the next couple of days as we have high pressure sitting on top of us, providing us really today with no cloud cover even. And so we don't have any rains to talk about. We don't have to worry about anything tonight. And into tomorrow, it's going to be absolutely beautiful with that high pressure system sitting on top of us and providing us the beautiful sky conditions. In the meantime, across the nation, we've seen rough weather today, especially over the central plain states, with severe weather having been recorded. Texas and parts of Arkansas and all the way up into Missouri, all expecting to see some rough weather for later on today. And we're also looking at some wet weather moving along a low pressure area across the northern plains. So from the Great Lakes area all the way back into eastern Texas, we're looking at the wet weather. But right here, we've got that high pressure system sitting on top of us as it skirts off into the Atlantic. We'll start to see warmer temperatures coming on in, and we could actually see some temperatures in the 90s in this upcoming work week. So expect to see very warm conditions. We've got a beautiful start to the work week. We're going to see another beautiful day on tap for tomorrow with no clouds in the sky. No rain is in the forecast. We have highs reaching into the 90s, possibly by Wednesday. We could see those kinds of temperatures around, and it will be dry through the forecast period. If you're heading out to the beach, winds start out of the east and then transfer around towards the southwest, 5 to 10 knots, seas 1 to 2 feet with a light chop. The temperature at the beaches will be 80 degrees, the Gulf water temperature 77. And for tonight, we get down to 61 degrees. It's going to be clear and we're going to be comfortable. And then tomorrow, it's going to be beautiful all the way through Thursday with the possibility of some rain coming in on Friday and Saturday with warm temperatures for most of the forecast period. Max?
Now, sports.
All right, Wendy, thank you. The Tampa Bay Lightning, one win away today from reaching the Eastern Conference Finals for the second straight year. The Bolts up 3-1 in their series with the Islanders, and Tampa Bay jumping ahead early on. Victor Hedman starts things off with his third goal of the playoffs, 1-0 Lightning. Just a few minutes later, Matthew Carl, he's going to find Brian Boyle, who wrists the puck in for the quick goal, 2-0 Tampa Bay. In the second, Lightning on the power play. Hedman, he's not done. He nails his second goal of the game to increase the lead. It is now 3-0. Jumping ahead to the third, same score. Nikita Kucherov on the break. No one stopping him. And there is the dagger. 4-0 Tampa Bay. The Bolts blank the Islanders and head to the Eastern Conference Finals. Ben Bishop with 28 saves in the shutout. The Lightning will take on the winner of the Penguins-Capitals series. And the reason we don't have a winner yet in that Capitals-Penguins series is because of what happened last night. Pittsburgh one victory away from winning the series. They could not stop Washington. The Capitals defiant, taking game 5, 3-1. Alex Ovechkin led the way with a goal and an assist. Game 6 will take place in Pittsburgh on Tuesday night. All right, to the diamond now. The Rays pursuing their fourth win in a row today out west against the Angels. This one just wrapped up. 3-1 the final. The Rays win their fourth in a row. Tampa Bay getting homers today from Kurt Casale and Brad Miller. We'll have the highlights coming up at 11. Well, yesterday at the Kentucky Derby, a horse named after a Detroit Red Wings hockey player took the first step toward capturing the Triple Crown. CNN's Coy Wire tells us more about Nyquist.
Over 167,000 spectators here at Churchill Downs witnessed the 142nd running of the Kentucky Derby. This was the second largest attendance in Derby history. Nyquist, the undefeated equine, entered this race as a heavy 2-1 favorite, and he showed why. In the final furlong, Nyquist ahead of the pack with Exaggerator, making a valiant surge, but he'd fall short. Nyquist, too fast, too strong, securing his lead and capturing the run for the Roses. Final time, 2:01.31. Exaggerator comes in second. Coming in third was Gunrunner. Now, with this iconic win, Nyquist has proven he's a force to be reckoned with. A perfect 8-for-8 in his lifetime of races. Owner J. Paul Redham bought the horse for $400,000. But with this Derby win, Nyquist's career earnings jumped to $4.56 million. So, Nyquist proving to be a pretty good investment. High hopes for Nyquist now. Could he accomplish what American Pharoah did just last year when he became the first Triple Crown winner in 37 years? We'll know more in just a couple of weeks. May 21st, when Nyquist will make a run for the second jewel in the Triple Crown at the Preakness. Coy Wire, CNN, Louisville.
All right, Coy, thank you. And some sad news tonight. University of Alabama Birmingham running back Greg Bryant has died after he was found shot on a Florida interstate. Authorities say Bryant and another man were discovered in a car with gunshot wounds on I-95 in West Palm Beach on Saturday. Both were taken to the hospital for treatment, but we have just been told he died this afternoon. The passenger only had minor injuries. Police are seeking witnesses. Bryant started his career with Notre Dame and recently transferred to University of Alabama, Birmingham. He was only 21 years old. The investigation continues. That's a look at sports. We'll have more news after the break.
I'd like to wish a happy Mother's Day to my mother, Suhair Al-Hassan. She's incredible. She's always been there for me.
I'm going to see her after work. I'm surprised her. Yeah, she don't know I'm coming.
And to all our family and friends, happy Mother's Day, and all to the great moms out there. Hope you're having a wonderful day.
Happy Mother's Day to everybody.
How to stay fit over 50, Tuesday on ABC 7 News at 5. At ABC 7, it's all about being here for you. Introducing ABC 7 News at 7 with award-winning investigative journalist Alan Cohn. In-depth reporting and debate on important issues and stories in our community with a featured topic of the day and a live roundtable discussion with community leaders and newsmakers. Plus, a quick recap of the day's top stories and weather. ABC 7 News at 7, weeknights. Now more than ever, we're here for you, Suncoast. Monday at 5 on ABC 7's Good Morning Suncoast.
Hello, I'm Rebecca Vargas.
And I'm Don Brennan. Rice cereal, a go-to for parents looking to introduce their little ones to solid foods, but a growing list of studies is raising new concern.
Monday on Good Morning Suncoast, we'll show you why it could cause changes in diets for children. John?
We're watching a change in our weather with increased humidity and warmer temperatures.
Monday at 5 on ABC7's Good Morning Suncoast. We're here for you.
You can check on them. You can worry about them. You can even choose a car for them.
Honey, are you okay?
I'm okay.
Love.
We're okay.
It's what makes a Subaru a Subaru.
Keep them safe. Go to Sunset Subaru in Sarasota.
Hey, Vanna, have you heard about the new Wheel of Fortune lottery game?
You bet. It's the ticket for some lucky lottery players to come here to Hollywood.
For a chance to participate in a private, non-broadcast taping of Wheel of Fortune with us.
Play the Florida Lottery game for a chance to win up to $250,000 instantly. And enter to win a VIP trip to Hollywood for a chance to win up to $1 million. Non-winning tickets only.
Play the new Wheel of Fortune game today.
Scratch, spin, and win.
And finally tonight, check this out, an unexpected grand opening of a farmer's market in Kentucky. The goal was to walk 7 goats a few blocks on Saturday, and volunteers signed up to create a human barrier around the animals. Well, they really didn't do a very good job at it, as the goats ran away, forcing organizers to chase after them. Oh, the goats ran through some streets, even into some bushes. Volunteers found most of the goats at a nearby park, but as of this morning, Wendy, some of the goats are still on the loose.
Oh my goodness. Well, somebody will find them and bring them in. Oh my goodness.
Yeah, it's funny. Seeing the video, even the police were chasing after them.
And this is in Kentucky, so yes. This is very close to the Derby, right? I mean, mm-hmm. This is kind of close.
I didn't see what city in Kentucky.
At Covington, I think it was. Covington, I thought it said. So it
wasn't. Not sure how far that is from Louisville.
I don't know.
Forgive
either.
Me.
I can't remember. I don't know either. But we are looking at some beautiful weather for the rest of tonight. So if you are going out to do any kind of barbecuing or doing anything tonight with your family, it'll be a great night to do that. We've got a great start to the work week, too.
All right, Wendy.
This upcoming week.
Thank you so much, and thanks for joining us tonight. We will see you back here at 11 o'clock. Happy Mother's Day again, everybody.